We're going to right click on it. We're going to click on new application. You're going to get the wizard. We're going to leave everything as the default. We do have an application with source files, so we are going to click next here. So publisher, I gave it Microsoft, application name, Office 365. You are able to give it a version. It is optional and the language is up to you. But the publisher application name, this is what I gave it. Again, like I said, I change it. Click next here. Source directory, you're going to click on browse and we're going to go into the desktop where that Office 365, you're going to set the entire root. That's what we want. It's actually going to take all the content within Office 365 and import it into our deployment share. So select the root, click OK, boom, click next here. Destination, I left it as the default. That looks pretty nice and sweet. Click next, and then this is where the magic happens. This is the command that we need to provide. We need to call that setup.exe file, give it a space, forward slash with a switch of config, space, and then call out your configuration.xml file. That's it. That's where the magic happens. Click next here. You get a nice little summary. Click next. It's going to start importing the content behind the scenes within your deployment share. And once it's completed, you should get this. The process completed successfully. Yes. Click finish. You want to create a task sequence, and it's a really straightforward task sequence. I'm going to go over it with you right now. I'm just not going to finish it. So the way that you create the task sequence, just select the task sequence node. You're going to right click on it, new task sequence. You're going to give your task sequence an ID. I'm going to call it Office. Give your task sequence a name, 365 apps installation. I mean, it's again, it's up to you. Give it a comment. TSR number 061, today's episode 61, yeah, I'm going strong. Click next here. Your template is going to be a custom task sequence. We're going to click next. We're going to click next here, and we're going to click finish, right? So I already have this guy. This guy is the one that we're going to use, but I'm just showing you guys how to do it. So we just created a custom task sequence. We're going to double click on it to open it up. And a couple of things that we want is basically go into the task sequence. Once we're in the task sequence, it already has what we want, install application. So I don't really need to do anything other than click on install a single application, click on browse. Once you click on browse, we only have one application. And we're going to click OK. And then from here, we're going to click apply and OK. And we want to go into our MDT server and we want to go into the deployment share. Now, I got to do a dollar sign because the deployment share is hidden. So once you do whack whack MDT, MDT is the name of my MDT server. Super simple, right? Deployment share, or if you change the deployment share name when you created your first deployment share within MDT. It's a lot of deployment shares in there. Give it whatever name with the dollar sign. I kept it as the default and I'm going to click OK. So once you're in here, we are going to go into the scripts folder. And once you're inside the script folder, we are going to get to the section that says light touch VBS, this guy right here. This is the one that we are going to double click on it. Let's see if we zoom in. Boop. Yeah. So this is the one that we want to launch. So we are going to double click on it. So there goes the task sequence. So select it, click next here. We need to authorize it. So this password would be used for logging onto the computer after a restart. So give it a, this would be like the local admin password. Now you have to give it credentials. Now this credentials is you're validating the connection to your deployment share. It's kind of weird because I got into the deployment share and I was able to start up the light touch VB script. So it's weird for it asking this, but okay. This guy right here, it's installing the application. Install Microsoft Office 365. Got the little black window over here, which is the setup.exe file. and it is going to start the installation. Cool.